Postal tonight.
Huh?
He has Victor Postal. I thought I'd just make you smile.
But man, you know what? Well, whatever. I mean, whatever you want to do, that's his business. Because he couldn't have whooped me in his fucking day anyway.
So. I got to ask you really quick, before I forget, how's Roger doing, your brother? We all love him. We're rooting for him. Is he doing okay?
Man, I can't really say what's going on with Roger. I mean, you know, he's... I don't know, man.
There's good days and then rough days.
Yeah.
But wishing him the best. Because he's a very, very good person.
Thank you. Appreciate it. Yeah.
Well, thank you so much for your time.
You,
always
man.
A pleasure.
Thank you, man. I appreciate you, man. Great seeing you again, man. All right. This has become every weekend, man. I saw you last week in L.A. and here in L.A. Thank you. I appreciate you. You got to keep the legacy alive. You know, keep the legacy alive.
Man, how many shoes do you have? Because every time I see you, you have a different pair of shoes.
He always got one-piece suits. He got like 10,000 one-pieces, you know.
You said what happened now?
How many pairs of shoes do you have at your house? Like, how many rooms are just shoes?
Wait a minute.
A big collection?
Huh? What about the shoe?
Yeah.
Oh, man. This...
That's like the Ali shuffle. Salsa. Yeah. But have you ever met Ali?
Huh?
Have you ever met Muhammad Ali?
Yeah, I met Ali when I was in grade school. I never met him when I was older. I met him in school. He came he came to my school in Grand Rapids. It was I think I was about in I was real young.
What year was that? Because Malcolm X had a mosque in Malcolm X had a mosque out there. That's what I was asking.
I've never seen Malcolm X.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
What did Ali tell you? Do you remember from that visit?
He didn't tell me nothing. I wouldn't fight nobody.
But he was a little kid.
I was a little kid then, man. So,
he and your son are considered the greatest of all time.
There it is. You better believe it.
And your son made so much money outside of the ring, that's incredible for an athlete. Number one athlete, more than anybody. He, Michael Jordan, and Tiger Woods, billionaires. With a B.
Never been done before.
No?
Never been done before. Over, no franchise in this world went over 20 years without
undefeated,
a loss.
You're right.
No franchise. You can look at hockey. You can look at
Lakers soccer. Had a 33-game win streak.
Yeah. I mean, no franchise, no professional athlete, for that matter. Then everybody talk about, you know, what his greatest purchase was, or, you know, they talk about, you know, his airplanes or like, his diamonds or whatever. I believe that he said so himself. His greatest purchase was that contract back from Bob Arum. You know, he did what he had to do to buy his contract back. He regained his independence.
Yeah.
And only one other time has that worked with success was with Jay-Z, when he bought his contract back and he started to own his things again. So what people don't really know about Lil Floyd is he owned the rights to all his fights. You know,
he did the right thing with Jay-Z. He did the right thing with him. He did the same
What's up, champ?
Hey.
Leo.
All right.
Nice. Oh, by the way, Jesse Vargas had a knockout last night. You trained them too.
Yeah. That was Junior, right?
So, there you have it. Another great video for ES News. For ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Elie Seckbach, reporting. And you can follow me on Twitter, at Seckbach. And you can follow me on Instagram, at Elie Seckbach.